Hari Om, parents, teachers, and my dear, dear children. You've been sitting here quite some time, and the children have presented a very, very lively, dance drama on the Gita Dhyanam. I have very few words to say, but I bring you the blessings of our Pujya Gurudev, Swami Chinmayananda, who loved children, who loved the youth, who loved the people, and he always had confidence that our country is great and we all have to make ourselves greater and make our country even greater. We all in our life want to study, want to become successful. Yes or no? Yes? Want to be successful or no?
Yes.
Successful, yeah. How much successful you want to be? That much louder you have to be. Do you want to be successful? To be successful, first of all, you must always be grateful for what you have. See, God has given us this beautiful world. God has given us such lovely parents. God has given us this very capable body. And God has also given us this opportunity of a good school, good teachers. Having got all this opportunity, and we say that we can't be successful, we can't be good, we are afraid, then we are not grateful and make use of what we have. One day, one mother brought her little son to a great master like Gurudev and told that this son of mine is always sad. Are you sad or you are happy? That is good. You also want to look sad or you want to smile? Smile. So you should smile all the time, no? You must be happy all the time. But when we don't get what we want, we become sad, no? Yeah? We become sad? And then when we got too many wants and too many complaints, then we're sad all the time. No? This boy was like that, sad all the time. So the mother brought the child to Guru and said, this child of mine is so sad. He doesn't want to do anything. He doesn't believe in God. So that sadhu kept him beside himself and said, beta, why are you so sad? You got such good smile. All of you got beautiful smile or not? Smile. You got such a beautiful smile. Why don't you smile? He said, I don't believe in God. He said, are, I didn't talk about God. I said about your smile. Yeah, but I'm not happy. So he said, why are you not happy? He said, because I don't have all the things that others have. I don't have my own computer. I don't have my own phone. I don't have this. I don't have that. I don't have that. So that sadhu told him that if I give you all this, will you be happy? He said, of course I'll be happy. But there are many people who have got all that and they are also not happy. He said, but if I get all this, I'll be happy. He said, okay, I'll give you. What is it that you want? Now you can think about all the list of things you want. What would you want? Yeah? He said, I want these good shoes. I want these good clothes. I want this, I want my own cell phone. I want my own pad. I want my own bicycle. and then my daddy must have his car to take me to school, and all this he made such a big demand. I must have my own room. So the sadhu said, how much do you think it costs? He said, I don't know. He says, everything that you have asked, car, your own room, big house, everything, suppose it cost 1 crore. I give you all these things. What are you going to give me for this? So many items worth 1 crore. He said, if I had money, I would have bought it myself, no? I would have bought it myself. So he said, but you have to give me something for so many things if I am ready to give you. What are you ready to give me? He said, I don't have anything. He said, okay, I will give you all these things worth 1 crore. Can you give me one of your legs? Anybody ready to give one leg for 1 crore? You ready? 1 crore? Car, bungalow. He said, no, not my whole leg. So he said, okay, just give me your feet. Anybody ready to give the feet? No. He said, okay, give me just your toes. Anybody ready to give their toes? He said, okay, just give me the finger of your hand. Anybody ready to give fingers of the hand? Okay, one finger. One finger for 1 crore. And he said, no. And that Gurudev said to that child that one finger of yours is more than 1 crore. Because for 1 crore. Okay, 2 crores? 3 crores? Each finger is worth more than this, and we complain that we don't have anything. God has not given us anything. God has given us the arms to work, the legs to walk, and given us the ability to achieve whatever we want to achieve. Is it not? And given us such lovely parents, such lovely teachers to equip us, to teach us how to live our life. And if after that also we complain that I can't get this, I don't have this, I am sad, that's why I am bad, then we are not grateful for what we have. And if we are grateful for what we have, then know that God has given us many, many wonderful things. Only we are not making good use of it. He has given us a mind. He has given us the ability to concentrate, but we don't concentrate. He's given us the ability to learn. And when we learn at the right age, then as we go up in life, we can achieve great things. So one of the good values that we must have in our life is gratitude. Always, every day, don't pray to the God, just say, give me this, give me this, give me this, give me this. But pray to God and every day make a list of all things that you can be thankful for. No? Can you tell me what things you can be thankful for? Think. What things can you be thankful for? Thank you, God, for? Or for? Parents. Thank you, God, for? Good teachers. Thank you, God, for? This able body. Some people don't even have that. No? Thank you, God, for giving us so much, so many plants, so much food, so much water, such pure air. We should not pollute that air. We should not waste water. We should always be grateful for what we have. And then we'll realize that we've gotten plenty and we can do a lot and we can achieve a lot. This is what our Gurudev used to teach all the children. And if this we remember, all good values will come in our life. So always pray to God, thanking God for whatever God has given us, whatever our parents have given us, whatever our teachers are giving us, whatever the whole of nature is giving us. Right? So, can we say a big thank you to God? Say, thank you. Thank you, God.
Thank you, Gurudev.
And when you go and meet your parents, just give them a big hug and tell them, thank you, parents. What will you say?
Thank you, parents.
And what will you tell your teachers every day? After the class is over, you must get up and say, thank you, teacher. Yes. And then, whenever you touch any plant, don't break it. But thank the plant for giving you oxygen. Thank Mother Earth every day to bear our weight. Thank the clouds that they give us rain on time. Like that, if you live a life of thank you, you will realize that you've got so much in your life. You're the richest of the richest, and there is nothing that you cannot do. Have you heard that song? My God is so great, so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. Think, have you sung that song before? Let's sing. Yeah? My God is so great, so strong and so mighty.
There's nothing my God cannot do.
There's nothing my God does not give. So I should be always thankful, always happy, and always smiling. Yeah? Sometimes we don't get what we want. So what? We should be thankful for what we have. Okay? So keep smiling always. Smile always? So smile. Smile, 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 smile. Big smile, big smile. Yes, so keep smiling all the time. And Gurudev's blessings with all of you, all teachers, parents. Besides just getting marks in school, it is the values that they get in school that goes to help them in all that they do in their life. If they grow up as children of values, of character, of love, of gratitude, and the readiness to work, and with dedication to society, then such children will be a delight for the parents. So I wish you all the best and have a very joyful life together as a family, whether at home or in the school. Hari Om, children.